How to add a text caption to your photos using an advanced method. This time we can't open the photo in our Apple Photos app. We need to use a third-party app. In this case, it's Snapseed, which is made by Google. And this is a free app, which makes what I'm about to show you even more amazing. So you open up your Snapseed app, and then you need to tap anywhere to open a photo. And so I'll just touch here. Now, if you have a photo here already, you would then just touch the open in the top left corner. But because I have a blank screen, I'm just going to touch this big plus or anywhere on the page. And it then opens from this menu anyway, showing you some recent photos, but I'm going to touch open from device. Now, Snapseed is accessing your Photos app and all of the moments and albums that you have there. So I highly recommend that you add any photo that you're wanting to work with or add text captions to your favorites first, just to make it easy to find. So I've done that here. I'll just touch on favorites and I'll touch on this bottom photo of the sunrise at Coolum. And yes, this is the photo I want to use. So I'll touch on use here in that top right corner. And now it's added that photo to Snapseed. And you can see it's suggesting filters straight away, and I could very quickly touch a filter and change. Look, I've really lifted up the color there, pretty impressive. And I'll hit the tick button here to say, yes, I'm happy with that. But we're really here to add some captions. So if you touch the pencil icon on the right-hand side here, you get a bucket load of choices. Now, I'm not going to go through all of these choices today. This video is purely for adding a text caption, and text is this option down the bottom. So if you touch on text, it then says double tap to change the text. And you can see already it's pretty big and bold, and it's much different to the other examples I've shown you. So I'll double tap, and strangely, I have to double tap a second time. So here, double tap here to change the text. I'll do that again. And now I'm going to type Coolum Beach Sunrise, just as I have on those other in those other videos, and hit OK. So now you can see it's a totally different style of text, and I can take my fingers here and just pinch this in to make it a lot smaller and then put it in place, and it's a totally different feel to the other styles. It's much more dynamic. And if you want to change the color, once again, you can touch color here and you have a huge option of colors to choose between. So here I've made that orange just as I did in the previous video. But I'm going to touch here on style. And if you touch here on style, you can see we have an enormous amount of styles to choose between, from, you know, a thin line here. I might just move that text up so you can see what's happening. I'll touch style again. Here's a thicker line, so you can see it's a bit bigger there, and we can touch on any of these. And for that matter, we can still pinch and rotate and move this to wherever we want it to go. I'll touch on style again, because you can see here, there is just a huge amount of styles to choose between. So I'm going to make this color back to white and put it up the top. So once again, lots and lots of styles here. And I'm just scrolling across the bottom to choose. Oh, here, look at that badge, and look at that. This is a more advanced method of creating all of these different styles, but how dynamic is that? I mean, you can just keep touching these and it will change, and you just find the one that you like. I mean, it's incredible, whether you're doing this just for fun, for your own photos, or even doing marketing if you own a business. I mean, you can make some pretty advanced stuff just with a couple of touches. So once you're happy with the overlay, the text overlay, you then tap the tick in the bottom right-hand corner. And after you've touched that tick, you'd think, okay, we're all done, or what do I do now? There's lots of options around here on the screen. But what we need to do, as I move my little microphone symbol out of the way, is touch on this share button in the bottom right, on the bottom right edge. And when you touch on the share button, you get the option here to save with the changes that you can also undo This is actually going to save it back into the Photos app that we came from. So I'm going to hit save. It's applying all of the edits that we chose, and then it's saying allow Snapseed to modify this photo. So this is actually modifying the iCloud version of the photo. So yes, we do want to hit modify. And now that photo has been saved successfully. So it's still sitting here kind of in Snapseed for you to play and work with. But in reality, if I click the home button on my iPad and I open up the Photos app, we'll now see here is this photo that I've just done in the Snapseed program. So as a comparison, here is the photo. It's the same photo. That's just with that filter applied. Look at the lift that that filter gave it. Pretty incredible, hey? So this is the same photo with a filter and the text. That is using the Camera Plus program, and that's using the straight out Apple Photos program. Now, to be fair, if I hit edit and applied a filter, I could make this photo more vivid in the Apple Photos program as well, but that Snapseed one's pretty good. I could add a little bit of color here if I wanted to try and make it more comparable to that filter there. But wow, look at that, what Snapseed did with that quick edit. I have a feeling I'll be using Snapseed a lot more. It does take a little bit more practice, but look at that result. For me, being a big Camera Plus user for a long time, I think Snapseed might have it. It's worth learning this advanced technique. I think you'll get a lot of enjoyment out of your photos when you start playing with this app.